If I will not be tarry till I come, what is that to thee? Follow thou me. And I want to, for a subject this morning, you simply follow Jesus.
Follow Jesus. Amen.
Follow Jesus. On this fifth Sunday after Easter, the Sunday before Pentecost.
Yes.
It is interesting, we see here this simple response and command from Christ. Follow thou me.
Yes.
It begs us to ask ourselves the question, who do we follow?
All right.
You know, it's funny because in this time of social media, whether it's on Facebook, you can follow people so that their posts pop up in your timeline before other people's stuff, and then you are considered a follower of that person. In Twitter, and, which our president loves to use entirely too much, you can be a follower of somebody on Twitter so that every time they tweet, you get the information. You become a follower of that person. Following somebody, though, is something that each and every one of us do from time to time, every day. You don't have to be on Facebook or Twitter to follow somebody.
Amen.
Matter of fact, you can be riding along in your car following somebody who is ahead of you.
Yes.
But it's interesting in this dialogue between Jesus and Peter this morning, as Christ is preparing himself to ascend and preparing the disciples for the reception of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
He decides to do something in a moment that many of us have trouble doing. He decides to go and to make amends. Why do you point that out this morning? Because prior to Pentecost, Jesus wanted to make sure that everything was in order.
Yes.
You remember he had a private conversation with Peter when he first called him. But the scripture reminds us that as he called the disciples, many of them, he simply just said, come follow me. Peter, he had to pull to the side and have a private conversation with before Peter decided to follow him. Peter became one of his most trusted confidants, one of those people on the inner circle, one of the top level disciples during that time. However, it was also Peter who, after they were at the Mount of Transfiguration, that spoke up first and said, Lord, it's good to be here. Let us make temples for you, Moses and Elijah. And he misspoke. Well, unfortunately, that wasn't the only time that Peter would misspeak during their time together. For Peter says in the company of the other disciples, Lord, they are going to fail you, but I'll go with you all the way. Even to death. Jesus then looks at Peter and warns Peter about his impetuousness and says, Peter, you yourself will deny me three times this night.
Yes.
But prior to that, if you remember, Jesus had said something to Peter that I think many times we forget in our critical analysis of Peter, because Jesus had told Peter that Satan desires to have you, to sift you as wheat.
Yep.
But when you're converted, strengthen your brothers. And I love to point that out because that is a testimony and a testament to the fact that Jesus, even though he knows we will fail, he has faith in us.
Yeah.
See, we sometimes get upset with people because we put our hopes and our dreams and our aspirations and lock it into them with hopes, and we, none of us think that the people we love will fail us.
Man.
But we got to be honest this morning, all of us have failed somebody sometime.
Yes.
I didn't do everything my mama wanted me to do.
Uh-huh.
I didn't make every decision that she thought I should have made. I failed her. I don't do everything my wife wants me to do. I don't do everything my children want me to do. Every now and then, I fail somebody.
Yes.
And the problem I think we have in life sometimes is we attach our hopes to people, and we do not expect them to fail. And for Peter, in his relationship with Christ, Christ looks at Peter and says, I know you're going to have a tough time. I know you're going to say and do some stuff I don't like, but I have faith in you.
Right.
And that faith is locked in the verse where he says, and when you're converted.
Yeah.
Because the word when means up to himself.
Yes.
And everything would be all right.
Thank you, Lord.
On the cross, as Jesus was being led before he goes to the cross, Peter denies him as Jesus says three times. Jesus goes to the cross and dies and wakes up, and many times on Pentecost, on Resurrection Sunday morning, one of the things that we overlook is that conversation between Peter, the angel and Mary, when he says to her,